Hi children, a very good morning. Hope you all are fine. In this video, we are going to see about queries in MS Access 2013. We have seen already chapter 1 and 2. Now we are going to learn chapter 3. Now what are the things we are going to see in this lesson? We are going to gain knowledge about the queries first. Queries are the fundamental means of accessing and displaying data from tables. So, this queries is used for accessing and displaying the data. Okay, queries can be accessed a single table or multiple table. You all learned this in chapter 2, a relation database. In that, you can add one or two tables. So, this queries can access a single table or multiple table, like that relational database table. You can use queries to view a subset of your data or to answer question about your data. So if you want to see anything about your query data, you can use this query. And also to answer your questions about the data, we can use this query. A query can be based on tables or on other queries. So it can be based on tables, okay, the tables what we create, it will be based on that or else other queries. How to create a query? Creating query can be achieved by using either the query design view or query wizard. So we can use this query design view or else query wizard. Now see, your query design view is here and your query wizard is here in the queries. So click on the create tab. So this is your create tab. See, it is highlighted in red color. Now that is your create tab. Click on the create tab and you can see the option in the queries group. So these two options will be present in the queries group. To create a query in a design view. How to create a query in a design view? Open the tables on which you are going to create your query in the query design view. So you have to open the table. First we have to open the table and then you can then use the show table dialog box to add tables or queries to the query design. So next thing is we have to use the show table dialog box. Then use the option in the design view to create your queries. After that, using the show table, you have to click on that design view options. The next one, then click the run button to display the result. After doing all these, after that we have to click on the run button. You can save queries for later use also. So once you have done, you can save it for the later use. Next one, in this chapter we are going to use the Access Query Wizard to create queries for a single table. So now see, this is your single table queries. Single table queries are useful to gain a view of data in a table that only displays certain fields. Okay, it will display only certain fields, that is column in the output. Sorts the record in a particular order. So this will sort the record in a particular order. Perform some statistic on the record, such as calculating the sum of data values in a column or counting the numbers of the records, or filters the record by showing only those records that matches some criteria. So you all know what is sorting, arranging the data in particular order, and then filtering. You all know that how to filter. Okay, so for example, show only those bank customers living in GA. Now see, your table consists of your students database. For example, your table consists of the student database, and then in the students database it consists of class from 1 to 12. So you are in class 8. You need only class 8 data. So you can use this filter option and then you can find out the result to your class. Okay, am I clear? So it will display only the particular table. Using this query, we can display only the particular table. The next one, creating a query using query wizard. How to create a query using the query wizard? So click on the create tab. You all know where the create tab, the create tab is highlighted here, the red color. Then click on the query wizard button. The next one is the query wizard button. And when a new query wizard dialog box appears, select the simple query wizard option. So this is your simple query wizard option. Then click on okay, here is your okay button. Then you have to click on the okay button. Okay, the first step in simple query wizard is to specify the table for the query and which fields should be displayed in the query output. So which thing you want to display in the output. In a table, it consists of marks and then rank, grade. Okay, in that, what you want to see, that thing you have to mention. Now see, this is a simple query wizard dialog box. They are given add field button, add all field button, then remove field button, remove all field button, like that it will be option will be given there. You can enter whichever the option want for you. The next one, three main sections of this step are, there are three main sections. Okay, the first one, tables or queries, a pick list of tables or queries you have created. Okay, the first one. The next one, available fields. All the fields created in the table will be displayed. So here, all the fields created in the table will be displayed. The next one is your selected field. Those fields selected from the variable available field will be displayed. So selected na available means it will display all the thing, and then selected field means display only the selected field. Now, in our example, the customer table is selected and the field of customer table alone are displayed. So here the only the customer table is selected and the customer table is displayed. From the list of available field on the left, move the ID, name, address, city and state fields over the selected field area on the right. So you have to select the particular field whichever you want. Highlight one of the field and then click on add field button. So after selecting the wanted field, then you have to highlight that by clicking on the add field button. Now right arrow, see here, right arrow button in the center between two areas. Repeat this for each of your four fields to be displayed. So here they are four, they are given you four field. If you want to give all the field a query table, then you have to click on all the field and repeat these step for each. The next one, when done with this step, the wizard shows should appear as shown here. After doing all these, the wizard should appear like this. Click on the next button to move to the next and final step in the query wizard. Now see, at this point the wizard will create a new query with the option to either. Now see, this is your query wizard. You can see in your book it is not clear ma. Open the query to view information. After doing that, you have to click on open the query to view information. The wizard will execute the query and show the data, or else modify the query design. A wizard will switch to design view to allow further notification of the query. These are the two options present in this. You have to click on any one. For example, let us view the information by clicking on the open the query to view information option. So see here, customer query, and then click on finish button. The customer query table appears and information is displayed under the table. Okay, now the customer query is created and the information will be displayed here. See, you can see this picture. Okay, that's all for today. Just go to this lesson and if you have any doubt, you can feel free to ask. Okay ma? Okay, take care. Bye.